Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. Scary.
No.
A little
bit.
No. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and on this episode of Superstar Save Point, we got Jason Jordan.
One half.
The amazing American Alpha. What was your nickname?
It failed me the first time, but you know, maybe it'll bring me good.
You can change it if you want.
No. It's funny because he actually texted me a little bit ago, and he's in my phone as Dick Wellington. So it just pops up.
We're playing Disc Jam with Dick Wellington.
Yes.
What have you been up to since you got handled in Mortal Kombat?
Actually, since then, I have won in Madden.
Yes.
My partner. And then I also lost in Madden.
I was going to say,
because I lost to Swags.
You got ate up in Madden.
I wouldn't really say ate up. Come on.
I got ate up. It's hard to watch. Okay, so you've been on the show a few times, but you haven't had had a solo episode, so we can learn about you.
Ooh.
So if there was one thing, we're going to do this like a dating service, if there was one thing that people should know about you when they meet you, what is it?
That's kind of like serious.
I know.
Like right off the bat, like just coming in hard. That, I guess now for, so the new thing is now that I'm married.
Okay, congrats. Yeah. I would say that the one thing that people should know about you is that there was one situation in when we were in FCW, so it was pre-NXT, that when I found out you're the strongest human on the planet. So he was like amazing Olympic wrestler and just like ultra badass. And so Breeze and I were like, hey, you know what? We can take you 2-on-1, it's fine. And we started like wrestling with him because like I wrestled, Breeze wrestled a little bit. So we're like, yeah, we got this. And in like maybe 45 seconds, he had us both in a bear hug.
There's different level. There's different degrees to things like.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't say degrees because it's not like a black belt or anything. Like that.
Kind of, but if there was, you'd be a black belt, right?
Yeah. There's levels to this.
Yeah. Stuff. But I mean, I was like, I amateur wrestled. I could take him. I could go a little bit, but that wasn't the case.
You were hoping that it would kind of go like this. Well, actually, it was the inverse.
Yes.
It was the opposite.
But what is again, you said this is the training. This is the training.
Yes.
You're getting it. And it's hard to talk while you play video games.
It is. Well, no, it's not hard. It is hard to talk while you play video games. It's very hard to talk and play a new game. So I'm like trying to think about like.
It's very true. So anyway, okay, so you're real strong.
Yes.
How'd you get so strong?
Because I amateur wrestled for 15 years.
15 years? Jesus.
Yeah.
What age did you start?
Seven.
I wish I would have started when I was seven. I started when I was like in seventh grade, so what, like 12 maybe? But there's things that you don't know when you're coming in that late in the game. Like, we would see the kids that started wrestling at 5, 6, 7, and like their switches, they look the same when they would do a switch, but
it doesn't. It feels different.
Yeah,
it's like the timing and like a little bit of a switch of the hips.
Yeah,
as I'm thinking about this, I guess there's some things that I missed when I mentioned my wife. No offense to her, but
she has a mean switch on her?
No, I probably should have mentioned some other things before mentioning my wife. One thing you should know about me, my wife.
Yes.
I guess we could say I'm better than I let on for wrestling.
Yes.
Because
100%.
Yeah, I never got like status with wrestling.
Yeah.
So like All-American, National Champ, any of that, like I didn't get, because I qualified for Nationals 3 times.
Yeah.
Yeah, came extremely close and didn't get any of that. So like when you would typically, like, you know, Gable, you could say he was an Olympian, he was a National Champ, like world medalist and stuff. He was all that.
Yeah.
I had the potential and have beat guys of that status.
Yeah.
But I had trouble with the NCAA national tournament.
And why?
Because it's tough.
What, you mean you can just walk in and win? What's wrong with you?
No, I wish.
So, in short, you're probably one of the best amateur wrestlers on the planet.
No.
I'm going to say yes. No. Best amateur wrestler on the planet. Could you beat Gable?
Because
you're like...
So here's the thing.
What's the weight classes?
I'm much bigger than
you guys,
I would not be in the same weight class.
What if you did wrestle? Life and death.
I will say this, folk style, I think I would have him. you understand this because you wrestled, but
yeah. So we'll explain.
Greco, no.
He's a throwing machine.
I don't.
He's got a lower base.
I never wrestled Greco.
Oh, okay.
So I always.
There's differences in wrestling. Some is just wrestling for points, and then some is like throwing.
Yes.
And that's way fun. You just get to throw humans.
And different point systems and different rules.
You have to wear toga.
But you have to go back to the Greek times.
Nice, you got the cutters going. There you go. Dang. Okay.
You just got a lot of points for that one. I see what you did there.
It's a good volley. But you're learning the game now.
I get it.
You're learning the game.
And you're learning about me.
Yeah. But okay, so best amateur wrestler in the world, what was your favorite music to warm up to? Because before amateur wrestling matches, you're in your jumper, you're bouncing around, you're getting hype, getting ready to rip somebody's face apart. What was your song of choice or album, whatever?
So I didn't really go album, but there were a few songs that I like, don't really even listen to anymore ever since.
You're just done with amateur wrestling.
matches. I don't know if you had that song, like when you had like a warm-up song and like you just had a bad beat.
Oh,
so
hell
it's
yeah.
like I can't listen just to that
done.
Song ever again. There was a song called Roger That with like Young Money, like Nicki Minaj. So that was one of the songs that year for me. So my entrance song for dual, like for dueling
hell yeah,
to
yeah,
college,
yeah.
And I never lost to this one, was Forever.
There it is. You got it? Okay.
Drake, nice. Eminem, Lil Wayne.
You should use that as your entrance music.
Yeah. Let's see what we can do about that.
Go in the room and be like, hey, well, I need this. We got a big match coming up. We got to have Drake here.
Yes.
Wayne has got to be here. Full band. Mine wasn't as intense. I would listen to either this Swedish speed metal band called X-Tol, which is, they're amazing, or the majority of the time I was listening to the soundtrack for Sonic the Hedgehog 2.
Ooh.
And my coach one time, he found my burned CD. It's a wrestling warm-up mix. So for whatever reason, he puts it on like during warm-ups at practice.
Yeah.
And I hear the da 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 da. And my coach is like, what the hell is this? I'm like, why is my music playing? He's like, why are you listening to this? This is my CD before matches. He goes, you're listening to video games before you warm, like before you go wrestle? He's like, I'm like, yeah.
And look at you now.
Yeah. But he would always like make fun of me because he's like, dude, you're just listening to this like jazzy, like mellow video game music. I'm like, yeah, because I tried to wrestle angry. I can't wrestle angry. It's too much. I'm like so unfocused. Like I would need like a beat in my head that I could like bounce to. Like
I hear you.
Because you know you wrestle at someone else's pace, like you're screwed. But I just had a super slow pace, shooting a double, can't get it. Okay, whatever. Maybe like throw a wizard in there. Okay, no, nothing. Well, I'll just let them take me down. But let them. So then we just roll into some sort of like jujitsu cradle thing. Clearly, I wasn't as good at wrestling as you.
A little unorthodox.
Very unorthodox wrestler. Nice. We'd always touch the face. Make him blink. Always touch the face.
I used to, like, in high school, that was, like, the thing.
Yeah,
like,
go to sleep.
It was always, like, touch.
Yeah, yeah.
Touch, go. And then, like, in college, it was just constant, like, it was a constant fight. Like,
yeah.
Because it was literally, we called it hand fighting. It was literally just, like, constant, like, pulling on the head. Like there was no time to just tap and go.
Like, somebody's just trying to rip your face into the mat.
Yes, it's just war.
Because the coach would say, where the head goes, the body follows.
It's true.
And you're just bucking people down.
Yeah.
That wrestling is rough. If you guys don't wrestle, and you are high school or elementary school, you should try it out.
Yeah.
It teaches you how to be an adult.
Hey, that's what got me here.
Yeah. See that? And look at him now. Look at him now. Part of America now.
Look at me.
Mm-hmm.
Just look at
killing
me.
Killing it. Killing it.
Finally getting the hang of this game.
Maybe yeah, yes.
Maybe I can win a set. As I slide the other way.
Okay, so non-wrestling.
Yes.
TV shows, what are you watching?
Ooh, so I've been waiting for Game of Thrones.
Yes. Oh, yes. Who's your favorite character?
I'm a big fan of Daenerys.
Okay.
I think she's...
My queen.
Yes.
My God. She's...
Incredible.
Like, too much. It's too much. I don't know if it's a character or, like, her... But whenever I see her, I'm just
so
like,
I've seen her in other movies, and I like her. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I like her, but something about like when in Game of Thrones, like she's great.
Exciting. I think it's like the whole like I'm the queen of dragons.
Yes.
And I will burn your area to the ground. Yes. Like, yes
and
please.
I think it's also a link because, like, originally, because I was late to the game of Game of Thrones.
Okay.
And originally, like, right away, I was like, ooh, Khal Drogo. I was like, that's great. Like, I love him.
Yeah.
And then, you know, sorry for people who are
going to start watching. Oh, it's fine. Spoilers!
Spoiler alert. Yeah, he dies in the first season. Yeah. So it's like, well, I guess I need a new favorite.
She's the closest thing to him.
Yeah. But, yeah, like, those two right there. Are,
yeah. Okay, what else?
What other show? Orange is the New Black is something that we
I had to stop watching.
Yeah?
How deep are you into it?
I'm all caught up. Okay. I've just been waiting for the next season.
After a couple episodes of season 3, is that when she goes back in jail, and then Alex goes back in jail? Because she lied for Alex?
Yes.
So, once...
And then Alex winds up, like, so she's out, and then she winds up getting put back in jail.
Yeah, so... What got me is how she lies for Alex.
Yep.
She has to go back to jail, and she watches Alex get set free. And then when Alex comes back, the first thing that she does is not punch her in her mouth.
Oh, yeah.
You put me back in prison? I'm in prison because in the first place? Now I'm in prison again while you lied to me and got set free?
You're like, I'm done.
Yeah, I legit turned it off as soon as that happened, and she like spoke to him. I'm like, how are you? I'm like, oh, I'm done with this show. I can't watch it. It's not real, and all that she talks about is how she's so upset she's in jail. Alex puts her back in, and she's like, cool with her.
Yeah.
No! Like, you're done! You're done! I'm getting a lifetime sentence!
You wanna be in jail!
Yeah! At that point, God. So.
I can't help it, though. I was still interested in it.
I feel like you were a fan of Crazy Eyes.
I do like
Crazy Eyes. You seem like a Crazy Eyes guy.
She's funny. I know. Well, one of the things that I really like about it, so did you know that that character was, like, not... It wasn't supposed to really be a thing. Like,
so
she was only supposed to be in like 2 or 3 episodes.
No.
But she just like killed her character so much that they're like, we have to keep her in there for a little longer.
Dude, that's awesome.
They just kept her in there, and she became such like a big part of the show.
Yeah, dude, she's sick.
Yeah,
a lot of the actresses on that show are just amazing.
Yeah. Oh, okay. You know what show I really like?
What?
And I feel like you would be somebody who would be into it.
Can I guess?
Yeah.
House of Cards.
No.
Is it a Netflix show?
Yes.
Netflix original?
Yes. The Get Down.
I haven't watched The Get Down.
No.
I started watching the first episode, and then something happened, and I had stopped watching.
And you said no. So it's not
a
show for you.
No, no, no. Not that I didn't like the show. Like, something happened in my house that I had to take care of. I don't remember what happened. Something happened with my fridge. My fridge, like, almost exploded or something. And so it put a whole damper on everything, and I just forgot to start watching it again.
Yeah, The Get Down. I love it. But I feel like it's a show that you can get into.
Okay.
It's like, so you know the basis of it, since you
started 60s, watching it. 70s?
Yeah, it's like in New York, and it's basically like right when like disco is still big.
Yeah.
But like, it's basically like the birth of hip hop.
Okay.
And like Grandmaster Flash and everything.
Okay.
So it's pretty cool.
I can get with that.
Yeah.
So we'll wrap this up. So last question, favorite song and why? On the spot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like I'm not like very good with like favorites.
Good.
Like there's way too many like good things mm-hmm. out there.
Okay, so if I give you a 10-second timer and you gotta answer it in
10 seconds.
10, 9.
Michael Jackson, 8. Man in the Mirror.
Ooh, hell of a jam. Hell of a jam. And why?
And the why.
Yeah.
There's like every time that I hear that song, it just literally makes me feel like good and like makes me feel like, yeah, like I should go change the world, like do good things. That makes me feel like I should be a better person, I think.
Yes. So if you haven't listened to Man in the Mirror, then first off, what
then
are you
I'm gonna
doing?
Change your world right here.
So go listen to
And then you're going to cry because then you're going to realize, oh my God, Michael Jackson, he's no longer alive. He doesn't make music anymore.
Has to change his ways. Great song.
No message could be any clearer.
If you want to make the world a better place, got to look at yourself and make a change.
We don't even do it justice.
Oh my God,
not
no.
bad though, you know?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good. We should do a Michael Jackson rendition. Yeah. Did you hear... that Elton John has finally made a video for Tiny Dancer.
Really?
Yeah. Like 40 years later. Oh, you got it!
And that's how we end.
You won!
That's how we end.
Perfect!
Yes!
Okay, hell of an end! You got the game!
Yeah.
That's how you learn Disc Jam in 10 minutes. Okay, sweet. Okay, wrap this episode up. Make sure you follow me, Austin Creed, on Twitter, @XavierWoodsPhD. Follow Dick Wellington on Twitter at
Jason Jordan JJ.
Follow the channel on Instagram and Twitter at Up Up Down Down without the O's. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight.